Hello friends. Today, I thought we will discuss something about a very important topic. Why do marriages fail? Of late, we can find that, you know, many marriages are happening with a lot of celebrations and everything. But how happily they are living. In the movies and all, we'll see, you know, after great trouble and all, people get married and it is assumed that they live happily hereafter, forever or things like that. But that's not the reality. So recent statistics that was taken in 2020, okay, it says by God's grace, India, the statistics is 1% divorce rate, whereas in US, where so much of individualization and the concept of, you know, privacy and freedom is there, we have 39% of divorce rate. So this is the statistics. But here we cannot say that, oh, India is fine and things like that. I feel in India there are a lot of cultural limitations. Many people don't express that they are in trouble or they are not so happy and everything. And for smaller issues, they don't take it to a bigger level, kind of a divorce and everything. So with a lot of limitations and restrictions culturally, socially and other things, people don't take it to the divorce level, but there is so much of separations, physical separation and emotional, psychological separations that are there. People may be living inside the house but with so much of separation among them. So that is highly prevalent in India, which is not coming as statistics as divorce rate. Whereas in US it's not the case, everything is registered. So that may be the reason why in India the number is less. I find, being a counselor, that there are so many marital conflicts and adjustment problems between the couples, which are making them live a adjustment life. You know, they are not happy. Many families, many couples are not happy, but we got married, okay, this is how it should be, and it goes like that. Whereas with few couples, we can see that they are really enjoying their married life. One thing that I would like to tell you is that if the parents or the couples are not happy, they may have children, they may become parents, but if the parents are not happy among themselves, it will have a reflection on the children. Kids also will not be happy. They will not have a proper childhood, which is why a lot of abuses and everything are happening. Child neglect is happening. Lack of love, basically, is the main reason behind the unhappiness that is prevailing among the couples. Generally, maybe husband may think that, you know, the wife doesn't love me like how much I love her. The same thing, the wife also thinks that I love him so much, but maybe he doesn't love me. So there is always an yearning for love, and they feel that there is lack of love. Now, love is a quality, okay? So people who are having love will be kind, will be compassionate. This reference, I found it in the Bible, and I'm sure it would be there in other religious books also, because every religion basically speaks about love only. Okay, so the qualities that are given is love is kind, love is compassionate. See, if you are in love, you will not shout, you will not be rude, you will be patient, you will not be jealous, you will be forgiving others, because there is love. You understood? So, these are the qualities of love. What do you mean by a quality? What do you mean by a quality? Okay, see, for that, I think it's better that we can give an example of rain or sun. What is the quality of a rain? It waters the earth. It doesn't water one particular place. If it rains, it rains to all of them. Good or bad, or whether they appreciate rain or not, whatever it is. If it is a quality, it is for all. So what are the qualities I said? Kindness, compassion, not being jealous, and not being rude, not shouting, and forgiving, patience, and all these things are the qualities of love, which means it is for all. There are people, I will be patient and kind to my family members, but not to my colleagues. So in that case, there is some problem there. That is, the love is not expressed as a quality. It is expressed as something different. It is focusing on someone. That itself is a selfish love. It is not a true love. So love is a quality. So if you are patient to one person, your patience is a quality which will be shown in every other place, wherever you are. So you cannot be patient to one person and you cannot be rude to other person, which means there is a disparity in your love, or there is some partiality in your love, and it is not true love. So that is what we'll have to understand before we understand the reason why there is conflict. Okay. Now we all have love in us. We all are lovable people only. But the love that is there in us, I think most of us do not have love as the quality, but we have love as an action, as focused towards someone, very specific towards someone, being itself very selfish. So we don't have, which itself makes it not 100% true love. Okay, so how can we check whether we have true love or not? For example, you really love your husband, or the husband loves the wife. And when you love your husband at the evening, or you expect your husband to love you back, to give you something, to appreciate you, and to do things that how you are expecting. If you don't get that, you get offended. You think that how much I'm loving, how much I'm giving my time, and he's not giving his time to me. So when there is an expectation and you don't get back what you really expect, you get frustrated, and that's the reason for the conflict. Am I right? Look at the same way, maybe you love your job so much. Some people love their job, they work like anything, and then they take initiative, they do a lot of programs, they do by themselves. But you have to check whether it is, they say that I love my job. It's true, it's good. But suppose people don't appreciate their work. Suppose people don't recognize their work. They get offended, they get frustrated. They say, why the hell am I doing all these things? And then they'll shout at others. Which means that love is not as a quality. It is focusing on something, or it is expecting something back in return. Now this is exactly the reason. Suppose some people love their husband's mother so much, and then when that same thing is not coming from the husband to your own mother, you start fighting. See, I'm doing this and you're not doing this. So this is all the problems, why the reasons for the fight between husband and wife, or the frustration and all the problems. So here, that is what is called. So our love is not true love. Now if we understand this, then we will know, where do I lack? Now you will be asking, see, what is the point in loving a person? And you know, it's human nature that if you have to get it back, no. Otherwise, what's the point? And he will be in his own way. He will not learn. He doesn't love me at all. Why should I waste my life like that? This is the reason for the divorce itself. But please understand, love is the most powerful weapon in this world. Most powerful weapon than anything else in this world. So if you give love without expecting anything in return immediately, you will definitely, it will melt the hardest of the stones. Your husband or whoever it is, they will melt, they will realize the true love in you, and then they will give back, maybe after some time, but it will come. A permanent change will be there, a permanent give back will be there. So you, that is what you really will get if you give your true love. Whereas if your love is only partial, if you are expecting things, okay, and if you're not getting it, you will demand it. You cannot demand love. If you demand love, maybe the others will love you back temporarily, superficially, artificially, which you also can realize. So this is the problem for the undercurrent, the conflict between the people. Many people have told me that he loves me, but I know it is not true love. He's just acting. It is not coming from his heart. What is the reason behind it? Because you are demanding it. Okay, so love cannot be demanded. So what you have to do is, you have to inculcate. First of all, you have to realize, where do you really stand? Are you expecting so much in return? Is your love true? If not, what to do? So first you have to realize, come to a realization. And then you have to earn for that. You have to cultivate to have the quality of love. And if this is how successful, happy marriage is, why people are very happy, some of them, it's because they have true love in them. The love is not reciprocal. They don't expect anything in return. So when that is there, there is true love. And that is called a divine love. That is spirituality. Otherwise, it is only partial love. Michael Fox said that family is not an important thing. It is everything. Family is the primary institution of the society. We need to have happy families. Only then we have happy societies. Only then we have happy nation. If not, everything will be very negative around. So it starts from the love between the husband and wife. So that is why I said that love is very important. Analyze, where do you really stand? Okay, so therefore get married and see to it that you are able to express true love, and therefore your marriages will sustain and be happy all the time, like how we see in the movies, happily ever after. Thank you. God bless.